your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me.
Good morning, Gallup Hill School.
Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would everyone please remain standing for a moment of silence?
Good morning, Colonel. Would everyone please raise their right hand and repeat the Bark Pledge with us?
I promise to be accepting, responsible, and kind.
Everyone may now be seated.
It's now time for a morning announcement.
Where the sidewalk ends. There is a place where the sidewalk ends and before the street begins, and there the grass grows soft and white, and there the sun burns crimson bright, and there the moonbird rests from his flight to cool in the peppermint wind. Let us leave this place where the smoke blows black and the dark street winds and bends, past the pits where the asphalt flowers grow. We shall walk with a walk that is measured and slow, and watch where the chalk-white arrows go to the place where the sidewalk ends. Yes, we'll walk with a walk that is measured and slow, and we'll go where the chalk-white arrows go, for the children they mark and the children they know, the place where the sidewalk ends. Sarah Cynthia Sylvia Stout would not take the garbage out. Sarah Cynthia Sylvia Stout would not take the garbage out. She'd scour the pots and scrape the pans, candy the yams and spice the hams, and though her daddy would scream and shout, she simply would not take the garbage out. And so it piled up to the ceilings, coffee grounds, potato peelings, brown bananas, rotten peas, chunks of sour cottage cheese. It filled the can, it covered the floor, it cracked the window and blocked the door. With bacon rinds and chicken bones, drippy ends of ice cream cones, prune pits, peach pits, orange peel, gloppy glumps of cold oatmeal, pizza crusts and withered greens, soggy beans and tangerines, crust of black-burned buttered toast, grisly bits of beefy roasts. The garbage rolled on down the hall. It raised the roof. It broke the wall. Greasy napkins, cookie crumbs, globs of gooey bubble gum, cellophane from green bologna, rubbery, blubbery macaroni, peanut butter caked and dried, curdled milk and crust of pie, moldy melons, dried up mustard, eggshells mixed with lemon custard, cold french fries and rancid meat, yellow lumps of cream of wheat. At last, the garbage reached so high that it finally touched the sky. And all the neighbors moved away, and none of her friends would come to play. And finally, Sarah Cynthia Stout said, "Okay, I'll take the garbage out." But then, of course, it was too late. The garbage reached across the state, from New York to the Golden Gate. From there in the garbage she did hate, poor Sarah met an awful fate that I cannot right now relate, because the hour is much too late. But children, remember Sarah Stout, and always take the garbage out. Invisible Boy. And here we see the Invisible Boy in his lovely invisible house, feeding a piece of invisible cheese to a little invisible mouse. Oh, what a beautiful picture to see. Will you draw an invisible picture for me? Shadow Wash. I've never washed my shadow out in all the time I've had it. It was absolutely filthy, I supposed, and so today I peeled it off, the wall where it was leaning and stuck it in the washtub with the clothes. I put in soap and bleach and stuff. I let it soak for hours. I wrung it out and hung it out to dry. And whoever would have thunk that it would have gone and shrunk, for now it's so much littler than I. I won't hatch. Oh, I am a chickie who lives in an egg, but I will not hatch. I will not hatch. The hens all cackle, the roosters all beg, but I will not hatch. I will not hatch. For I hear all the talk of pollution and war, as the people all shout and the airplanes roar. So I'm staying in here where it's safe and warm, and I will not hatch. Band-Aids. I have a Band-Aid on my finger, one on my knee and one on my nose, one on my heel and two on my shoulder, three on my elbow and nine on my toes, two on my wrist and one on my ankle, one on my chin and one on my thigh, four on my belly and five on my bottom, one on my forehead and one on my eye, one on my neck, and in case I might need 'em, I have a box full of 35 more. But oh, I do think it's sort of a pity I don't have a cut or a sore. Pirate Captain Jim. Walk the plank, says Pirate Jim. But Captain Jim, I cannot swim. Then you must steer us through the gale. But Captain Jim, I cannot sail. Then down with the galley slaves you go. But Captain Jim, I cannot row. Then you must be a pirate's clerk. But Captain Jim, I cannot work. Then a pirate captain you must be. Thank you, Jim, says Captain Me. The Silverfish. While fishing in the Blue Lagoon, I caught a lovely silver fish, and he spoke to me. My boy, quoth he, please set me free, and I'll grant your wish. A kingdom of wisdom, a palace of gold, or all the goodies your fancies can hold? So I said, okay, and I threw him free, and he swam away, and he laughed at me, whispering my foolish wish into a silent sea. Today I caught that fish again, that lovely silver prince of fishes, and once again he offered me, if I would only set him free, any one of a number of wonderful wishes. He was delicious. Forgotten Language. Once I spoke the language of the flowers. Once I understood each word the caterpillar said. Once I smiled in secret at the gossip of the starlings and shared a conversation with a housefly in my bed. Once I heard and answered all the questions of the crickets and joined the crying of each falling, dying flake of snow. Once I spoke the language of the flowers. How did it go? How did it go? The end.
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye!
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye!